Bicycle.
I want to ride my
bicycle.
I want to ride my bicycle.
Well, we're here again, second time. So, if it's as good as the first time, we'd be all very happy. This time, we're wrapping it up for the. I think I remember Morgan Sparrow in this one. So, he's got all the guys with me, brave and safety. And the best luck to you all. Thanks, Terry. That's the cameraman. So, get lost now. Good luck to you. Next stop, America. See you in Mizzenhead. Malinhead.
Like the legend of the Phoenix, all ends with beginnings. What keeps the planet spinning?
Lads, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord, may the road rise before you all the way. And may the south wind blow. And the day, guys, we remember Morgan Sparrow offered this up for all morgues. So may the props of the 139 hover over us and the hand of Morgan be on our backs. Because I remember I told a story once when I was doing his mass on the pillar of the post between the calf and Finner Camp leg. I can remember I was on my last fig roll and the hills were blistering, so they were, and Bill Morgan came up with his hand behind me on my back, and boy, what a push. Got me all the way to Finner Camp, so God bless him. So we remember Morgs. And for all of those who we offer this up for, the cancer people and so on who can't do this kind of thing. So may the Lord bless and keep you, lads, and bless your bicycles and get us all there safely. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Enjoy it, lads.
I love it.
Charity, which is a respite home for people who have had chemotherapy and they're not yet strong enough to get back on their feet and look after themselves. So they can go into the residential home in the old Franciscan Friary, Multifarnham, and they can get a holistic treatment, they can get physiotherapy, and they can meet other cancer sufferers. The Lark home was set up jointly by Frank Russell, and it requires about $200,000 a year to keep it going. The Eta, who was the co-founder, stipulated that she didn't want anybody to have to pay for the treatment. And this was after going for a treatment after she had a double mastectomy in England, whereby they charged her £4,000 for the week's treatment. And she wanted to set up something similar in Ireland that could be available to people. In terms of cancer, of every four people, two are going to suffer from cancer, cancer-related illnesses, and one is going to die from it. So what we're doing is, okay, we're having good fun, but you know, everybody has raised over €400 for the charity, and they've worked hard to do that, and they've put a lot of money by bit since February in the current economic climate. It's a tremendous achievement, and it's a terrible testament to the commitment everybody has put into it.
Yeah! Yahoo, God, Jerry!
bit. Okay, go ahead. Take it away, yeah.
Hey, what's your prediction for the fight, Mohammed? Pain.
I didn't know that I'd ever go this far with a compass point driving ink into my arm. The Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. We don't talk too much, never been that close. Pouring spirits while I follow the northern star. And as the birds fly south, I've been missing a small house that holds all my words and precious gold. I found your message lying at the bottom of the bottle. Come back to where the streets are paved with stone. I believe in you, you believe in me. You're the lighthouse in the storm. Swap the scent of open ocean air for the factory steel and the engineers. Well, I'm coming back to something beautiful. All the noise and all the lights are all the things I'd sacrifice. I'd trade it for the way you make me feel. And as the days they pass, falling through the hourglass, it used to be beneath my feet along the shore. I found your message lying at the bottom of a bottle. Come back to where the streets are paved with stone. I believe in you, you believe in me. You're the lighthouse in the storm. I believe it's true, I can follow you. Back to where the streets are paved with stone.
Look at that side, look at that. That's a Brook saddle, guys. That's what my arse has been sitting on for the last 300k. And my arse is up feeling perfect. You know? So, Brook saddle, guys. There's your answer. More problems. Blessings on all of you.
Back to where the streets are paved with stone.
To Castlebar, 113 kilometres, 35 riders. And in comparison to yesterday, this should be the easy day. Yesterday was 175 in lashing rain, so everyone's kind of delighted for a bit of a tailwind. It's about 17, 18 degrees. We're cruising along through Connemara, so where else would you want to be?
The only problem me torture, that's what happens when it's you that's standing in the path of a lightning bolt. Walks the walk with gritted teeth, but I just stand by and I wait my time. They say you gotta toe the line. They want the wall and not the wine. But when I see the signs, I'll jump on that lightning bolt. And chances, people tell you not to take chances, and they'll tell you that there aren't any answers. I'm starting to agree, but I woke suddenly in the path of a lightning bolt. Fortune, people talking all about fortune. Do you make it or does it just call you? In the blinking of an eye, just another passerby in the path of a lightning bolt. Everyone I see just walks the walk with grace.
4 hours 6 on the bike, and it's now 10 to 5, so we're within 5 or 10 minutes of our ETA. We're just at the roundabout in Castlebar. We now have 36 cyclists. We've one follower today, but he didn't do too much damage. I think his ego is more than anything else. So we now have Wednesday done, but only 2 days to go. We're in Castlebar. Relatively easy day overall, considering yesterday was so wet and cold and miserable. I think everyone enjoys the day. Had a nice lunch in Linan, as you can see. Spirits are high, everyone's happy and chatty after the race on the way in. So it's Castlebar now for food and possibly steak and maybe one drink, you never know. Over and out. Cut.
Morning again, ladies and gentlemen. Second last day, and this is St. Brendan on the way. He's the king of the road, king of the hills here. God bless you, Brendan. We'll get you there, don't worry. So, Brendan, over to you, and let them know how you feel.
Oh, I did.
Give me your blessing.
Blessing?
Yeah.
I wouldn't know what to say. Just hopefully we'll all get there today safe and sound. That's
good,
the main
good.
Thing.
How's your arse? Okay.
If that's fine, yeah.
That's good, that's good.
My quads are a bit sore, but
that's
back's well padded, so I'm all right.
God bless you, Terry. See you in Finner Camp, guys. Wish you were all here, but you can't be all here. Right? Can you? Banana for the road. Amen.
Just leaving Castlebar en route to Finner, home of the ex-search and rescue unit. It's 150 kilometres. It's going to be tough. We're into the wind already.
I've been trying to do
I'm starting to lose my breath already.
Okay, Mrs. Kamal on stage 4. We've just left Castlebar. Come over the windy gap there by Nathan. You might be able to see it in the background there. No? Can't see it. Yeah, interesting interesting climb when we weren't even warmed up. It's proving a wee bit windy. It's a bit rain there this morning, but once you turn across Malina, we're going to have a tailwind, westerly wind the whole way. In through Colooney, round by Manor Hamilton, and into Finner Camp tonight. So tonight's Thursday night, we'll be in County Donegal. One more day to go. Tomorrow's promise, high pressure, sunshine, barbecue up in Ballinhead. 100 minutes. Nearly 30k done now this morning. So we have about 120k to go today. Spirits are high, a lot of lads are complaining of sore legs, but otherwise, it's all good. As I said yesterday, where else would you want to be?
I don't think you're right for him.
Happy to be alive.
What happened?
Came round the corner and then everything went black. Or it actually went green, same colour as gorse. That's as much as you're getting. I'm saving the rest for Rolling Stone.
They're all behind you, Tony.
Yeah.
Sandwiches, ham sandwiches, chicken sandwiches, anything you want.
I should have them here today.
You talk to the guys, you welcome all the boys. You're on television now, so you're here.
I'll go away.
All the guys from Baldonnel, all very welcome. Peter Higgins and other guys. Best cook in the world. God in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Now, just before I should say the prayer, what you've done in the last week has been fantastic. And you've no idea of the inspiration that you're leaving behind you along the road there. People that see us, a few remarks that people made to me in the shops and whatnot. It's not just for the cancer patients that we're doing this. There was one guy there that was telling me, just yakking away at him in one of the restaurants. He's a bit depressed. And when he saw you guys come in your bicycles and all you're doing is explaining where we're going, where we're coming from, maybe I'll do something about this thing. You know, it's not just cancer, there's so many different forms of cancer around the place. It's depression, it's loneliness, it's people who are fed up with life. And when they see the likes of yourselves coming along doing what you're doing, it's really inspiring. So well done to you, lads. I'm sure the people that were doing this for the Lark group and those who are recovering from cancer will appreciate deeply too. And you, Frank, I'm sure will say more words to you. And we think of these guys too who gave their lives so selflessly in the cause of saving other people's lives. And so, Lord, we thank you for the gift of the last week, for the camaraderie, for the hills that we shared. And we ask you, Lord, to keep us between the ditches today and on the road. Are you Tom laying my hands on you? And too, God bless you. So may the Lord bless and keep you, lads. May he bless and keep your family. And may he use us. May he use us to bring joy, and peace and hope to many people who haven't got it. Almighty God bless you, lads. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Thanks,
well, lads. Jerry. Good stuff. All right, lads.
Sorry, we've just left Finner Camp on the way to Donegal Town. First up is Bally Buffet. We roll up to Bunkrana and all the way to Malinhead. Hopefully Malinhead for about 3:30 today. It's pretty cloudy and overcast at the minute, but high pressure's building, so we're hoping for about plus 20 degrees. Hence the reason we're all in shorts and t-shirts. Barbecue at Malin Hotel. One or two drinks, a few high fives, and it's back to Finner Camp tonight. 35 cyclists, we two that had to go home for family commitments. 25 cyclists for 155k. As you can see all the way down.
Stephen, you suck!
Spirits are good. You guys are happy.
Yeah, come on. They're waiting this thing.
Even Terry's happy, he's running along. All going well, 4 more hours. This trip will be over, okay?
Okay, we were here on Malinhead on Friday,
the 5th of July,
at about 4 o'clock. We've just completed 463 miles, which is almost 800 kilometres. We have no casualties, touch wood, everybody back safely. A tremendous logistical achievement by all involved, from the drivers, the outriders, the logs, the transport, accommodation, the fundraising, the clothing. Well, all in all, I think we've had a marvellous time.
And of course the media.
And of course the media as well. We can't do it without the media. But a tremendous achievement and some great fun en route. A lot of hard work. People are pretty fit now. Muscles are aching a small bit, but I think they're going to relax and enjoy themselves a bit later on. And we started off in sunshine and we're finished in sunshine. And we've seen some of the most magnificent parts of this country in all its glory, in all its weathers, good and bad. We've had tremendous hospitality along the way. People have been very good to us. We've hopefully raised over 10,000 for the Lark charity.
That was a great trip. We did approximately slightly different than what we did in 2010. We've seen a bit more of the scenery. We went over a lot more climbs in Cork and Kerry. More smaller roads in the burn, and then through Connemara, and then what we do past Nathan yesterday and through the Cage of Fields, and then all the way in through Manor Hamilton, and then today then was the Donegal Hills. So in terms of scenery and landscape, contrary to popular belief, the cyclists went on instead of getting more tired day by day. Today was actually our fastest day. Day 5 and we averaged 27 was our fastest day. Yeah. So it just goes to show that guys did a bit of training, kept themselves in shape, got some sleep at night, got some food. We're all getting fitter and fitter. You can hear the laughing in the background, it just goes to show spirits are high, so nobody's too tired, especially even after a nearly 800-kilometre trip. So it's back to a barbecue now, Malin Head. Yeah. The rest of the evening.
Indeed, thank you very much, and thank you for your time as well, Terry. And I might get a little piece before you go from Commander Humphreys.
Okay, it's Kevin Humphreys, a retired commandant from the Air Corps. This is my second Mizzen to Malin. Great pleasure to perform this particular challenge on behalf of LARC, which is founded by an ex-Air Corps commandant, Frank Russell, for rest and recuperation for people in cancer treatment. I also think, particularly when we left Finnair of the crew of 248 and all our deceased members of the Air Corps, those who died naturally, those who were killed in crashes. And of course, it's once again shows the great bonding and the great inspiration that the Air Corps gives to everybody. Anybody who's ever had anything to do with it, they'll always say they were the best years of my life in the Irish Air Corps. And Gamran Mishbio, Ernam Shorish.
Well done to Lieutenant Byrne for organising great Mizzen Malin, and just hard luck for the stage win today. Keep trying, keep your chin up, and keep cycling. Maybe next time.